Hey guys, I'm going to show you how to remove the side fairings to access the shock here. So that's the plan for today, and I'm hoping I can do it with just a Phillips head and a Allen set. So never done this before, so we're going to take it apart and see how it goes. First thing you want to do is pull off your seat, and it looks like there is some screws under there. Let's go ahead and take these loose. Not very tight. Looks like there's a piece right there. Alright. So I took out these two screws, and I'm going to take out this one down here where this peg is. I hope you guys can see it. It's not the right size. It looks like it may be a 4. Very tight. And it looks like it just kind of pops in place there. All right. That one out. I think that's it. I don't see nothing in there that would be holding that. Okay. Looks to me like it would just pop off now. Okay, and then you got one more tab down here. Oh wow, that was really easy. So two screws, three screws, and a rivet, it looks like. Now, let's see, here's the shock, so you got two points here. It looks like you can adjust the height of it, too. So, next thing I need to do is just kind of jack it up a little bit to take a little pressure off that shock. And let's see what size that is. Probably a 17. Way too big. All right, looks like it's a 14. Well, the shock is very easy to remove on the Z. On the Grom, it's significantly more difficult. Okay. That's it. That's the old defective one. And then now I gotta swap it out with the new and improved one. So I'm gonna stop it right here. And then we'll get back to action here shortly.